This is Coding Math Mini number 11, Canvas Drag and Drop. Now, as I go through these various episode, mini, and application videos, I'm trying not to use any mathematical concepts in the examples that I haven't already covered in the other videos. And there's been a few places where I really wanted to use some kind of drag and drop element in an example. The Bezier curve examples really could have used that. But since we hadn't covered this subject, I had to do things differently there. Now, to be honest, this subject is only marginally math-related, but there is a bit of subtraction involved, so I'm covered. We'll also be using one of the hit detection functions we wrote a while back, so there's that. Now, the basic strategy for drag and drop is 1. Listen for the mouse down event. 2. On mouse down, do some hit detection to see if the mouse is over a draggable object. 3. If so, then you are dragging. Start listening for the mouse move and mouse up events. In mouse move, you just set the object's position to the mouse current position. And in mouse up, this means you've dropped the object, so stop listening to mouse move and mouse up. That's all pretty straightforward, so let's get coding. This main.js file is set up with the usual simple template. First, I'm going to create a handle object to drag. The handle is going to be a circle here, so it has x, y, and radius properties. You could also do this with a rectangle. You just have to change the drawing and hit detection a little bit. Then we'll call and create a draw function. This will just clear the canvas and draw a circle using the handle's position and radius. Then we need to listen for mouse down and do the hit detection. I'll use utils circle point collision, passing in the handle and the mouse xy point. If you were using a rectangular handle, you'd use the point in rect function. Now, if hit test returns true, then we know we've pressed the mouse button down while the mouse cursor was over the handle object. So we can start dragging. To drag, we'll add event listeners for mouse move and mouse up, passing in functions named onMouseMove and onMouseUp. I'll create these as separate named functions so that they can be added and removed as needed. Now, in the onMouseMove function, we'll simply set handleX and handleY to eventClientX and eventClientY. And then we'll call draw. In this example, the only time we need to redraw the canvas is when we're dragging, so we can do it right here in the onMouseMove function. Now, if we had some other animation going on, we might need to use a request animation frame loop, and in that case, we just need to set the handle's new x and y in here, and we let the drawing be handled by that other animation loop. Finally, onMouseUp removes the listeners from mouseMove and mouseUp and ends the dragging action. This is the drop. So let's try that out. Okay, so we can click, start dragging, the handle moves. We let go, it stops moving. Brilliant. But if we zoom in a little bit, we notice something a bit strange. When we start the drag, the handle suddenly snaps so that it's centered on the mouse pointer. That's because we're setting handle X and Y directly to the mouse coordinates. But when you press the mouse button down, you likely weren't dead center on the handle. So you get that jump. But we can fix that. Back in the code, we'll make a generic object called offset. Then, when we start dragging, we set the x and y properties of this offset object. Offset x will be event client x minus handle x, and offset y will be event client y minus handle y. This offset object now represents the x and y offset from the mouse to the center of the handle. Now, in onMouseMove, instead of setting handle x and y to the mouse coordinates directly, we subtract the offset x and y first. This ensures that the handle is always at the same offset from the mouse pointer. So let's try that. All right, that feels much more natural, so our work here is done. But now for one final, more complex demo. I've decided to use our old friend, the Bezier curve here. The file bezier.js is all set up to go. I'll just walk through it. First, we have our four handles for the two endpoints and two control points of the cubic Bezier. Then I'll make an array, and fill it with these 4 points. This is just to make it easier to loop through them all. And then there's the offset object that we had before. I've also made a Boolean variable called isDragging. This kind of variable is often useful in drag and drop situations where you need to do one thing if you're dragging and something else if you're not. So you can use this isDragging as a flag to indicate which thing you should do. You set isDragging to true in the mouse down handler and false in the mouse up handler. You'll see how we use that in a moment. Finally, I have one more variable called dragHandle. Since we have 4 possible handles that could be dragged, we need to keep track of which handle actually is being dragged at any particular moment. In the draw function, I first draw the Bezier curve using the built-in Bezier curve 2 function. Then I loop through the handles array and draw each handle. But before I draw each one, I check isDragging and whether or not the current point is the drag point. If we are dragging, and this is the right point, I set some shadow properties on the canvas. This means that anything that is drawn after that will be drawn with a shadow. Then after drawing that one handle, I null out the shadow properties, so only the handle that's being dragged gets a shadow. The mouse down handling function needs to do hit testing on all of the handles. So again, we loop through the array. If it gets a hit, it sets isDragging to true, adds the mouse move and mouse up listeners, sets drag handle to the handle that it discovered the hit with, sets the offset properties, and calls draw. This will cause that handle to be drawn with a shadow, making it look as if it were just picked up off the surface of the canvas. A nice little touch. The mouse move handler is pretty simple. It sets the position of the drag handle to the mouse position minus the offset, and calls draw. Mouse up isn't too much different either. It removes the listeners, sets isDragging to false, and calls draw again to get rid of the shadow, as if you had actually dropped the handle back onto the canvas surface. Let's run it. So that's pretty slick. You can drag any handle around and update the curve in real time. The shadows add a nice touch, I think, and make it feel as if you really are moving around physical objects. So that's it for today. Not exactly rocket science, but I'm glad we covered this, as I'll now be able to use drag and drop elements in any future video. See you next time.